Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my beloved children, subhanallah. Today I want to talk about lies. When someone tells a lie, what happens? Do you know that the angels, Allah sets them around us to protect us? So at any given time, I have angels around me. They're known as angels of mercy and angels of protection. You need to know, nothing can harm you. Nothing can attack you. You don't need to be sad and you don't need to be afraid, because Allah has set around you certain angels. Now, they are angels of protection and angels of mercy. Those are a bonus that Allah gives the believers. And every time you read Ayatul Kursi and you read your last two or three surahs of the Quran, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, if you know them and you read them, then the angels protect you. Allah sends special angels to look after you. And these angels are excited to be with you and around you. So that's a very nice thing. Nothing can harm you. Nothing can attack you. Nothing can cause issues with you, inshallah, because you're protected by Allah through these particular angels that Allah sends to look after you. But when you do something bad, especially when you lie, then these angels, they're affected by this. And the angels go away because spiritually, your mouth starts smelling. There is a little smell that comes out of your mouth that you can't smell, but actually, it's a spiritual stench, you know, stench meaning a bad smell. So what happens, the angels are affected by it and they start going away. So I wouldn't like the angels around me to disappear, to go away. I want them to be there and I want them to always be around me, and I need protection because people might try to harm, people might try to do things. They can't do it when Allah doesn't allow it. So I need those angels, so I won't lie. And I won't lie because it's not nice. It's not the right thing to do. If we were all liars, what would happen? We would cause a lot of problems amongst ourselves and people would start fighting amongst each other because they would be lying to each other. So what's important for us to know is tell the truth. The truth will actually cause these angels to remain with you, even if some people don't like the truth. You have to say the truth. We as believers, we are taught to speak only the truth in a nice way, in a very polite way, but you must speak the truth. If you've done something bad, you can own up to your father or mother, your parents, or someone who loves you, and you can tell them, please don't react in a bad way, because when you or my father or my mother, when you react in a bad way to me as a child, when I tell you that I did something wrong or I made a mistake, then it's going to be hard for me to tell you next time because you get so angry, you get so crazy. So tell your parents, please don't get too angry with me. Don't get so crazy with me. Yes, sometimes I might need a little bit of a punishment. You know, we have a naughty corner in my house. We have a naughty corner. And sometimes when the little ones are naughty, they have to spend a little bit of time, go into the naughty corner, have a seat there, think about what you did, think about why it was wrong and why you shouldn't do it. And when you're ready, I will come and bring you or take you out of that corner. And after a while, I'll take them out of the corner and ask them, did you think about what you did? Yeah, I did. Was it right? No, it was wrong. I won't do it again. Thank you. You've achieved. MashaAllah. So in the same way, lies is something Allah doesn't like. So wallahu la yahdi, meaning inna Allah la yuhibbu, Allah doesn't love, Allah doesn't guide those who lie, those who are transgressors, and so on and so forth. One of the things is lies. So we shouldn't tell a lie. We should speak the truth at all times. And we should be very polite. The Prophet ﷺ, he was brilliant. He was the best of everyone. He was a lovely person. He always smiled and he always gave a good impression to people. Do you know, when he was young, he never ever lied. He grew up in such a community that knew him as the truthful one, the honest, the trustworthy. He was honest. Honest meaning never lied. He was always straightforward. So the Prophet ﷺ was given prophethood by Allah. He was protected. He didn't lie. That was a great quality. The people knew, this guy, no lies. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May peace and blessings be upon him. And may Allah bless every one of us with peace. So if you want that peace, don't lie. You'll be known as a truthful person. This person tells the truth. And yes, I do know sometimes our friends are a little bit mischievous. They have a little bit of issue here and there. But don't worry, Allah is great. May Allah bless you all, my beloved children. Remember the lesson today. And remember, we must make sure that we always do our best when it comes to doing the right thing, inshallah azza wa jal. I hope your Ramadan is going well. If you're listening to this during this Ramadan, because it's recorded in Ramadan, if you're listening to it right now, leave me a message on my YouTube channel, Mufti Menk Official, and I'll try to at least acknowledge it by the will of Allah. Don't lie, like I said. Speak the truth, and you'll be known as a truthful person. You get the blessings of Allah. Allah will not be displeased with you. The angels come and they will not run away. The angels of mercy and protection will enjoy your company. And at the same time, you will be a very dignified person, a lovely person, a nice person. Everyone will love you. And sometimes maybe your friends might not like you when you speak the truth because they were guilty. They didn't want you to say the truth. Now, you don't spy on anyone. We don't spy. We're not spies. We don't spy on anyone. But if you have to say something, speak the truth. If you don't have to say something, you don't need to say it. You can leave it out. And you achieve the blessings of Allah. Love you so much, my beloved children. And looking forward to seeing you again in our next episode. Until then, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.